Hello, welcome to the Guggenheim. I'm Tracey Bashkoff, curator of collections and exhibitions, and I'm co-curator of the exhibition upstairs, Art of Another Kind, International Abstraction, and the Guggenheim, 1949 to 1960. The 1950s ushered in a diversity of fresh, bold artistic styles and avant-garde associations on both sides of the Atlantic, from the abstract expressionists and the art informel movements to artist groups such as Cobra and Dowell Set. The revitalization of experimental art following World War II signified a renewed interest in freedom of expression, spontaneity, unorthodox materials, and earlier art forms. French writer Michel Tapier declared the existence of une art autre, art of another kind, a radical break with all traditional notions of order and composition in a movement towards something wholly other. Drawn from the Guggenheim's holdings, this exhibition upstairs considers 90 works by 67 artists and a decade of radical artistic development, despite the uncertainty, anxiety, and tension that pervaded the social and political arena of the time. The exhibition also brings to greater attention, we hope, lesser-known pioneers, alongside those that have long been since canonized and are most recognizable to our audiences. Art of Another Kind also examines a vital moment in the Guggenheim's institutional history when the museum opened its doors of this groundbreaking Frank Lloyd Wright building in October of 1959. The then director, James Johnson Sweeney, was the curator of the inaugural exhibition, and it featured more than 120 works from our collection. The selection represented, to a limited extent, the history of the museum as the Museum of Non-Objective Painting, showcasing works by Kandinsky and other modernist artists. But at the same time, the inaugural presentation also included 40 examples of contemporary painting and sculpture dating from the 1950s, and attesting to Sweeney's commitment to innovation and the art of his time. Sweeney championed those artists that he called taste breakers, individuals who, he said, break open and enlarge our artistic frontiers. And it's with Sweeney's wise words fresh in our minds that I'd like to introduce R. Luke DuBois and tonight's program, Composing with Patterns, Music at Mid-Century. I extend our gratitude to Luke and to Christopher McIntyre for taking up the challenge to research, conceive, and structure tonight's program. And I thank the numerous performers that are all listed in your program that you have in your hands. My appreciation also goes to the museum's education department for their thoughtful exhibition-related programmings that contribute to sort of our multi-layered examination of this 1950s era. R. Luke DuBois is a composer, artist, performer, teacher, and lecturer. He's collaborated on interactive program, performance, installation, and music productions, and worked with many artists and organizations, including Tony Dove, Matthew Ritchie, Todd Reynolds, Elliot Sharp, Michael Gordon, Maya Lin, Bang on a Can, Engine 27, and Lemur. He was the director of the Princeton Laptop Orchestra for its 2007 season. He teaches at the Polytechnic Institute of NYU and is on the board of directors of the Issue Project Room in Brooklyn. His discography is extensive, and his artwork has been exhibited at numerous venues, including the Smithsonian, the Chrysler Museum of Art, the Scottsdale Public Art Program, the Weissman Art Museum, and EVOM. I first met Luke in 2009, and this program marks the third time that I've had the privilege to see an exhibition that I organized enhanced by Luke's visionary interpretation. In 2009, he gave an interactive tour of our Kandinsky retrospective. In 2011, he curated music by which to view The Great Upheaval, which was an examination of works from our collection from 1910 to 1918. And I'm very glad that this evening he's agreed to follow me into the second half of the 20th century and to shed some light on the works that are upstairs. From my past experience, looking at the exhibition through Luke's eyes has always been quite moving and revelatory for works that I know very well. And so I'm sure, and it's with great anticipation that I expect tonight's program to be much the same. So please welcome Luke DuBois.